Hi, we need to know how to compare Java number instances. It's different than how you compare number primitives in Java. In this video, we're going to look at comparing Java number instances. For starters, since numbers are objects, we can't use the regular arithmetic operators. When we use primitive operators with objects, we're comparing instances, not the values inside the instance.
Be careful, because sometimes you'll get tricked into thinking you're comparing values. For example, if we create two integer instances, both with a value 42, an equality comparison of the instances will return true. Java is doing some sneaky stuff behind the scenes. And this fails for larger integers. Java just caches integer instances from minus 127 to 128. Lesson learned, the arithmetic operators are for comparing instances. When we want to see if two integer values are equal, the best option is to use the equals method. This is the same equals method we saw in earlier class tutorials. If we're comparing the values of two integers, we want to get the value out like this using the int value method. This returns the value as a primitive. Then we can use any of the regular arithmetic operators.
Java has a standard way for sorting objects. In order to sort object values, Java needs one method to compare objects.
The first compare method we'll look at is compareTo. This method is part of the interface comparable. A comparable object is capable of comparing itself with another object. The reason to implement the comparable interface is for sorting lists of objects, in our case, lists of integer classes. The comparable interface expects a method with the same signature as compareTo. The parameter is always the same as the object type. In the integer class, compareTo expects another integer. The method returns zero if they're equal, a negative number if the integer is smaller than the integer provided as a parameter, and a positive number if the integer is greater. This is used in the sort method for most collections. We call sort, and the collection will sort the group of objects using the compareTo method. Here's how we'd sort an array of integers. Define our array, then use the array class and call the sort method. Our array is now sorted. The sort method just takes an array of objects, so how does it know how to sort our integers? Well, deep in the arrays class, it's using the compareTo method.
Finally, there's a method to compare two integers as if they were unsigned. When Java was created, for better or for worse, they didn't include unsigned numbers. They thought unsigned numbers were too complicated and not really needed. Well, in Java 8, they changed their minds. It was too late to add a new primitive type, so they kind of smashed a weird solution into the integer and long classes using static methods. So we have a compare unsigned method.
This method compares two integers as if they were unsigned. That means the sign bit is also used for the magnitude. The catch is we're still using integer instances. The numbers are still signed values. They just added the methods and pretend the value is unsigned. We'll need more methods to access the bits of integer values. We'll look at the unsigned numbers and bit manipulation in the integer class in the next tutorial.
If you have any questions about comparing Java number instances, add them to the comments below. Next, we'll look at bit manipulation in the Java number classes. Now, if you like this video, please like it and share. That helps to get the video in front of more viewers. You'll also want to make sure you sign up for the DGU newsletter. I'll send the newsletter out about once a month, and it'll contain the month's videos plus tips and news not contained in the videos. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.